We wanted just to give you some scripture to help you out with that. It's one of our favorite verses, and it's in Psalm 139, and it's verse 23 and 24. And for us, this verse just really means a lot because you can make this a prayer. And it says this, it says, "Search me, O God, and know my heart, test my thoughts, point out anything in me that you find sad, and lead me along the path of everlasting life." I mean, that's a really great, that's a great prayer right
there.
Yeah,
it's a very introspective passage that you can make into a prayer. So let's just kind of show them what it would be like to turn that into a prayer. So they can
work
it
out. Just work it out right now.
Yeah.
As a skit.
Yeah.
Okay.
Go for it.
All right. Okay. She said, "Woo!"
I didn't know if it was... I thought there was a spider monkey out there. I didn't know what that was.
All right. Okay, here we go. Okay. Search me, O God, and know my... Search me, O God. What, Tommy? Tommy? You look a little constipated. What's going on? What's going on?
I am not Tommy.
You're not Tommy. Who are you?
Nay.
Are you a horse?
What, nay.
No. What?
I'm God.
You're God.
Yay.
Oh, search me, oh God.
Yeah, that's why God says yay and nay.
What are you? Okay, I'll go with it. What are you? Okay, you. What are you doing? What are you doing now, God?
I am smiting people.
Oh. You're smiting people?
Yeah, smite! You know, smite. You know, smite.
Yeah. Okay. Finished?
Yeah.
Yeah? Hmm. All right. Did you get him?
No, I spared him.
You spared him?
Yes.
I wouldn't have.
Okay.
No, come back. Okay. But you know what? We have skits where, you know, one of us plays God, you know, like God's chisel, that kind of stuff.
Okay, so, I'll be Jesus.
Well, we got skits like that too.
Okay, well, that's the two parts of the Trinity, so I don't know what you want me to do.
There's three parts of the Trinity.
I don't think so.
Yeah, you know.
It's God and Jesus. That's
no,
it.
No, yo. God in three persons, blessed Trinity. Yeah, so yeah.
Oh. I thought that was the three people singing it.
No, that's a trio.
Oh, so yeah. The Trinity is like a trio of God.
Yeah, Father, Son, Holy Ghost.
Oh.
Yeah.
Okay, cool. I'll be the Holy Ghost. Yeah. All right. I'm like Casper. I'm friendly, but I'm holy. All right, yeah. You can just call me HG, all right?
Okay. I'll call you God, but it'll be implied that you're the Holy Spirit. You are that still small voice.
That's what that is. I thought it was aliens.
No.
Feels so much better.
Okay. All right. So we'll just keep. Okay.
All right.
Search me, O God.
All righty.
What are we doing?
Yeah.
No, you are not.
Yep,
no.
You just relax.
I can't.
All right,
I can't relax. No.
A lot easier if you'll relax.
I can't.
Let me just get you to move right over here. All right. Just here we go. Just take a seat. Here we go. What are you doing?
I thought you were.
No, I don't like to get fingerprints on this.
Oh. Okay.
What did you think I was doing?
So what is this?
This is your heart right here. See that? Uh-huh. That's your heart. Uh-huh. And, your heart has muck and guck on it.
My heart has muck and guck.
Yeah.
Muck and guck.
I mean, that's what I see right there. I see muck, guck, and... Oh, there's some yuck. Yeah. Your heart has muck, guck, and yuck. Like a lifetime of bad choices covered with muck, guck, and yuck.
Muck, guck, and yuck. Seriously, that's what the Holy Spirit's going to say, muck, guck, yuck. Seriously, muck, guck, yuck.
Okay. You want serious?
Sure.
I'll give you serious. Your heart is a wellspring of life. You should guard it with all that you are because there is a great battle going on for the allegiance of your heart, and most times you're doing lukewarm at best.
Search me, O God, and know my heart. Test my thoughts.
There you go.
What are these?
Those are your thoughts.
These are my thoughts?
Yeah.
Not my thoughts. Yeah, there's no way they're about. These are my thoughts. Wow, wow. How did you get a hold of my thoughts?
Hello.
Right. Okay. All right. Okay. This is something for me to peruse a little bit later, and I will do that. Okay.
Let's just go through them right now.
Go through my thoughts?
Yeah.
I don't want to, not in front of all these people. I don't want to go through my thoughts in front of these people.
Why not?
Well, I mean, they're going to think what I think if they're thinking about my thoughts, and those are my thoughts that I'm thinking. If they're thinking my thoughts, I'm thinking, wow, those are my thoughts that they're thinking. That's a lot of thoughts to be thinking, you think?
Fortunately, I'm the Holy Spirit, so I understand those groanings. Look, let's just start at the top. We'll just go through. Just trust me, okay? It's not bad. Starting at the beginning, in the A's, you have some anger issues.
I don't have anger issues.
You really do.
I don't. No. Yeah, I don't have anger issues.
Well, I mean, your parents would say okay, that.
Okay, no. My parents come from a different generation. They don't get the world that we live in now, okay? So it's not anger, okay? It's appropriate frustration, but it's not anger, all right? Okay, all right, okay?
Okay,
okay, okay,
fine.
Okay, okay, okay?
Yeah, okay, okay. How about your friends? Your friends say...
Okay, my friends, I am the leader of my friends, and they come to me for advice, all right? And I give them advice, but they do not take my advice, and it makes me a little angry, okay? It gives me this. Do you see that? Do you see that? It gives me that, okay? But I am the leader, and they don't listen. Do you know what it's like to be a leader of a lot of people, and they do not listen?
Have you ever read the Bible?
I'm just saying, okay? I'm just saying that I think my anger is in check, and sometimes that anger can be very, very healthy in a lot of different ways, okay? It's an emotion, all
okay,
right?
Okay, okay, but the people that drive on the road with
they're
you...
They're morons! They're complete idiots! They are morons! They should all go to... an island, a secluded island where there are no cars and far, far away from me.
Wow, no anger problems here.
Okay, all right. I have a hang up and I will work on this, all right? I will work on it, okay? But I mean, does it really matter what I think?
Oh, yeah. As you think in your heart, that's who you are. Listen, you sow a thought. You reap an action. You sow an action, you reap a habit. You sow a habit, you reap a lifestyle. And it all begins with your thoughts.
But here's the deal. I can't erase everything in this book. I mean, it's my past.
I'm not asking you to erase it. I'm asking you to trust me with the story that I'm weaving through your life. It's called history for a reason.
History. His story.
Exactly.
Okay, well, that's good, though. Search me, O God, know my heart, test my thoughts. That's a lot, right?
It's a great place to start, but I'd like to go deeper.
Do we have to?
We don't. We don't have to go deeper, and to be honest with you, most of my children don't even make it to this point. But I have great plans for you, and I don't want you to miss out on anything, so I hope you'll trust me.
Okay. Search me, O God, know my heart, test my thoughts, see if there's anything in me that makes you sad.
What could I possibly do that would make you that sad?
What you doing?
I couldn't sleep, so I'm just, you know, I'm on the computer.
What's her name?
I don't know her name. I mean, it's just, you know, just a she, you know.
Well, it's obvious she's a she.
Hey, she's... your creation. I was just admiring your creation.
You ever thought about looking at trees?
You made those too.
Yeah.
Yeah. I'll look into that one.
She?
Yeah.
You don't even know her name. I know her name, and I know everything about her. And I know the plans I have for her, and this is not a part of it. And this, looking at women in a degrading way, this makes me sad.
Okay. Okay, I have a habit.
Great,
right?
Admitting it is the first step.
Okay, and I'm sorry about this. I really, really am sorry.
And you're forgiven.
I'm sorry. No, I didn't mean for this to happen.
I'm sorry, and you're forgiven.
Well, I'm sorry.
Okay, you know what? You need to quit that.
What?
Well, you say I'm sorry all the time.
Well, I'm sorry that I'm sorry.
Stop it. Okay. Listen, you've been forgiven. Receive my forgiveness. When you don't receive my forgiveness, you cheapen my grace. And this whole I'm sorry all the time, it makes me sad.
Yeah, but I
But what?
Nothing.
No, say it.
No, I wasn't going to say anything.
Yes,
no.
You were.
No, I was not.
Yes, you
no,
were. And now you're lying to me. And when you lie to the Holy Spirit, that makes me sad.
Well, I
Just say it.
No, I wasn't.
Say it.
There's nothing to say.
I dare you.
Can the Holy Spirit dare?
Just did.
I wasn't going to say nothing.
Yeah, you were. You were going to blame me.
I wasn't going to blame you.
Yes, you
no,
were.
No.
Yes, you
what?
Were. And listen, you blame me. You blame me. It's crazy because great things happen in your life. I get no credit. Something bad happens. Boom. It's my fault. You blame me for things. And it's not me. I didn't do it. And when you blame me, that makes me sad.
Okay. You're right. But I mean, okay. But look at me. I mean, me. Okay. I mean, me isn't a lot. Okay. And when I try to go out there and walk this walk of faith and I look at other people, I mean, look, Ray. Okay. Ray is a great example. Ray has it all together. He's a great leader. I mean, he's a good Christian.
He is a good guy.
He runs the race. I mean, when he talks, people listen to him. Have you seen this Christmas card of his family?
No, I have it on my refrigerator.
See what I'm saying? I mean, Ray, he just has it all together. Everybody loves Raymond, you know? And when I look at his life, and if I could just be a little bit more like Ray.
If you could be more like Ray, you know who you'd be?
Who?
Ray. I want you to try to be like me. This comparison thing, it makes me sad.
Well, isn't that just it, though? I mean, let's just be honest. If we're going to be honest and real, you're just tolerating me.
What?
Over my past, over my hurts, my habits, my hang-ups, all the things that I've done, you're just tolerating me.
Oh, listen, and catch this. Jesus Christ didn't die on the cross so that I could tolerate you. He died so that this relationship could be repaired. And when I look at you, I see his perfection, not your hang-ups.
I'm just worried with my life that I'm going to fail you.
You worry so much.
I was worried you're going to say that.
Listen, when you worry, you're not trusting me.
I trust you. No, worrying is showing you that I really, 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 really care.
No, worry is like a rocking chair. It gives you something to do and it doesn't take you anywhere.
That is good. Do you mind if I tweet that?
Not right now.
I'm really worried that I'm going to forget that. Okay. All right. Search me, O God, and know my heart. Test me and know my anxious thoughts. See if there's anything in me that makes you sad, and lead me along the path of everlasting life. Lead. That's an action word. Lead. Okay, so if I do more, if I get involved when I go back home, if I do more things for your kingdom, then I will see your I will honor you and I will see. What are you trying to do? What are you doing? What are you doing?
I'm trying to get you on your knees.
Well, it's not working.
Nope, this is all you.
Oh, you want me to pray?
Yeah.
I'll pray. That's cool. Okay. All right.
A little more.
Seriously?
Seriously.
Okay.
That's cute.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. But see, I think this is really a good emergent prayer stance, okay? Because There's so many things to do, all right? If my phone rings, I'm there. If a text happens, I'm there. I can pray, but I'm there. I'm always ready to go, all right? Always ready to do what I need to do. You know what I'm saying?
I didn't create you to be a human doing. I created you to be a human being. I just want you to be still and know that I'm God. And make this your prayer.
Why don't you just put me on my knees?
I can, but I don't want to, and you certainly don't want me to. Now, make the verse your prayer.
Search me, O God. Know my heart. Test me, know my anxious thoughts. Create in me a pure heart, clean up my thoughts. I want to live for you. Show me those things that make you sad and let me just go a 180 away from them and live the abundant life that you have for me. And lead me in the way of everlasting life.
There is a God who sent his son to die on a cross so that you could have a relationship with him. And the greatest relationships are the ones where people talk to each other. And he longs for you to spend time talking to him like that and listening to him like that, so that he can be your God and that you can be everything he created you to be. Talk to him.
Thank you.
Every song we could ever sing, worthy of all the praise we could ever bring, worthy of every breath we could ever breathe. We live for you, oh, we live for you. Jesus, the name above every other. Jesus, the only one who could ever save. Worthy of every breath we could ever breathe. We live for you. We live for you. Holy, there is no one like you. There is none beside you. Open up my eyes. Every breath we could ever breathe, we live for you. Oh, we live for you. Holy, there is no one like you. There is none beside you. Open up my eyes in wonder and show me who you are and fill me with your heart and lead me.
will, there will come triumph. You are strong in my weakness. Out of pain I see rejoicing, for you rise out of brokenness. For you rise out of brokenness. I will dance in the midst of the fire.
Be for Christ alone. justice is appeased. Jesus is crushed, and thus the Father's pleased. Christ drank God's wrath on sin, then cried, 'Tis done. Sin's wages paid, propitiation won. I praise to Christ and marvel at the cross. Jesus forsaken, God estranged from God. But by such love, my life is not my own. My praise, my all, shall be for Christ alone.
Jesus, oh, for grace. Sing with me, how great is our God.